Good evening, one and all. Welcome you all to Vayomanasa Sanjeevani's webinar series. There was a little technical error in the starting stage, so we are excused for that. So I welcome you once again, all the YouTube and the Zoom attendees for our session. Today's topic for the day is hypnotherapy. To talk about this, we have Dr. Dennis sir, and our moderator for the day is Mr. Srinivas Murthy sir. Srinivas Murthy sir, welcome you, sir. Dennis sir, I welcome you also. Srinivas Murthy sir, he is a volunteer of Vayomanasa Sanjeevani and a lay counselor at Samadhana Center. Now I welcome you, sir, to address our speaker for the day. On to you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Gina. Good afternoon, friends. Our resource person of today's session is Mr. Dennis Rodriguez. He is 69 years young. His education qualifications are BSc, MA in English Literature, MA in Psychology, MBA in Banking and Finance, MPhil in Management. List of postgraduate diplomas: Certified Associate of Indian Institute of Banks, Mumbai. Diploma in Public Relations, AP Open University. Diploma in Journalism, Mysore University. Diploma in ISTD, Training and Development. Diploma in Life Coaching, Blackford Center, UK. Diploma in Guidance and Counseling, St. Agnes PG Center. Professional Efficiency: Certified Mind Power and Law Attraction Trainer, Gestalt Therapist, NLP Practitioner, Certified Hypnotherapist. Mr. Rodriguez has served for 41 years in Canara Bank, successfully handled various positions in West Bengal, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Goa and Karnataka. Retired as a general manager and principal of Staff Training College, Canara Bank, Bangalore. Presently engaged as a managing director of Prudent Training and HRD Private Limited. Career guidance and counseling for students, family counseling, individual counseling. Corporate level trainer in mind power and law of attraction training. Resource person at St. Agnes PG Center for PG diploma in guidance and counseling course. Sir, Vayomanasa Sanjeevani is very happy to have you as a knowledgeable person as a faculty of today's topic. Friends, there will be a PPT presentation for 30 minutes followed by a live demonstration for 15 minutes. After that, participants can ask questions and give their opinions. Over to you, sir.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, sir.
Thank you for the opportunity. In fact, I have been in this hypnosis and hypnotherapy field for the past about 8 to 9 years. And it has been one of my dreams to be a hypnotherapist long time back. And today I feel myself very privileged to get some knowledge into this field. Today's whole program will be on these five areas. Number one is hypnosis awareness, an overall understanding of the subject, understanding our mind and the process of hypnosis, and therapeutic uses of hypnosis. How many people are attending right now? Maybe around
43, sir.
Sorry?
43.
Yeah. There are certain things, you know, the requirements that we need to have. One for demonstration of hypnosis, and second one for understanding of the concept. If you can have a paper and a pencil right now with you, That would be nice. Otherwise, then also it is okay. Even if you don't have, if you have, it would be very nice. Okay. These are, you can see the screen. There are 10 questions in this. I will read out the questions and you just have to tick your awareness on this, understanding of the questions. Hypnotists have special powers, yes or no? You don't have to do anything else. You just have an understanding. Hypnotists have special powers. If you have a pen and paper, you can say that number one, yes or no. Number two, hypnosis will work only on certain people. Number three, people who get hypnotized are weak-minded. I repeat, people who get hypnotized are weak-minded. Number four is when in hypnosis, that is when you undergo hypnosis, you can be made to do something against your will. Number five would be hypnosis can be bad for health, especially for mental health. I repeat this question. Hypnosis can be bad for health, especially for mental health. Number six is you can get stuck in hypnosis and unable to wake up without the help of the hypnotherapist. Number seven is you are asleep or unconscious when in hypnosis. You are asleep or unconscious when in hypnosis. Once you undergo hypnosis, you will be dependent on the hypnotist for whatever reason that you have gone to the hypnotherapist. In hypnosis, you will be able to recall everything that has ever happened to you. And the last one, number 10, would be hypnosis is dangerous and it is devil's work. Okay. Whether all of you have made either a mental note or on a paper. Okay. How many of you have got this? Yes answers. Yes for any of the questions. How many yeses you have got? You can unmute and say.
Three, sir.
Okay. Any others?
Four.
Four, yes. Okay.
Not even one for me, sir.
Not even one for you. Okay.
I have only one yes, sir. All no for me.
Okay. Anybody all else more than yes. Four? More than four yeses?
I've got three yes.
Yeah.
I've got three yes.
Three yeses. Anybody more than four? No. How many of you have got no's for everybody? No for everything. Every question. Me, all sir. The time. No.
Me, sir. Shakuntala, I haven't got.
Okay. Any others? Any others? No for all questions?
Yes, sir. Yes. No for all questions.
No for all questions. Okay. We'll move on. I will give you these are all the myths that we have. Actually, there is no yes answers here. All answers are no. All answers are no. You'll be surprised. All answers are no. I will give you the each and every question answer. Number one, hypnotists do not have any special powers. They use the client's mental ability and power to derive benefits of hypnosis. The more creative a client, more effective is the hypnosis. The second also is no, hypnosis will work on all the people. It's not confined to only a few people. The only exception is mentally sick people. Number three is there is no distinction between mentally weak or mentally strong people. In fact, disciplined and trained people get hypnotized easily. Military and other disciplined people have more mental imagery and they'll be easier to, it will be easier for a hypnotist to hypnotize them. Nobody can make you do something against your will, not even the hypnotist. Fifth also is no, hypnosis has been proved as effective tool for increasing mental health. There is no way you get stuck in hypnosis. God has gifted us with the mechanism of sleep, and you become aware when the effect of hypnosis is over. Question number 7 is, hypnosis not a sleep. It is a state of, neither asleep or nor unconscious. There is no such thing as dependency on the hypnotist. If you go to a hypnotist, it's not that, you know, every time you will have to go. It is your choice to decide whether to go to the hypnotist or not. Number 9 is, hypnosis has not been reliably used as a memory recovery tool. Though people are in an understanding that we can dig up the memory bank of a person, it has not been proved. But it would be easier for the person to focus and remember certain things during hypnosis. The last one is, it's a devil's work. No, it is, hypnosis is completely safe and proven method of relaxation. No occult powers are attributed to hypnosis. It's an ethical and safe method used in therapy since centuries, and this has been used across the globe. Okay, isn't it surprising that some of us got carried away by the understanding that we have on hypnosis? And that's exactly what happens. In fact, you'll not be surprised that every single person is having some or the other myth of hypnosis. And that is the reason why hypnosis as a therapy is not being catching up in India, in our country especially. But abroad, especially in US and UK, hypnosis has been given therapeutic license are given for hypnosis. Okay, the history of hypnosis is like this. I will not read out all these. History has hypnotic therapy or hypnosis therapy or hypnosis history has been going through a lot of ups and downs. And there are some significant people, those who contributed to the development of hypnosis. Number one is Avicenna. He is a Persian psychologist who was the earliest to make a distinction between sleep and hypnosis. He could make out that there is something which is not a normal sleep, which is, though he did not name it as hypnosis, he said there is something different. And after that, if you see the history, these are divided into two categories, like is magnetist. It's called as a magnetism. And second is mesmerism. Have you heard the word mesmerism? I am mesmerized with his a charm. We all use this, right? It has come from Mesmer, Frederick Franz Anton Mesmer. It's his name. His name has been given to mesmerism, and he used hypnosis in his practice. Then comes the other people were there, but one of the most important person is James S. Dyer, who came to India and practiced in West Bengal for many, many years. Almost about 20 years he practiced in West Bengal, and he had more than 2,000 medical cases wherein he conducted surgery on patients, the painless surgery. And in the 19th century, hypnotism is a very important people are James Braid and Jean Martin Charcot, who was very much interested in hypnosis. And in 20th century, we find Emil Coué. How many of you have heard this phrase like every day, in every way, I become better and better. Anybody has heard? No, nobody? You can, yeah. Nirmal Kaur and Srinivas. Yeah, every day, in every way, I become better and better. These words were coined by Emil Coe. These are auto suggestions. Then comes Sigmund Freud. Though Sigmund Freud did a lot of research on hypnosis, he left his research on hypnosis. Then comes Pavlov. Pavlov's dog. The psychology people would be knowing this. He also worked on hypnosis. Then comes Dave Ellman. Actually, Dave Ellman is the modern hypnotist who used or who developed his own style of hypnosis. Okay, moving on. The father of hypnosis is Anton Mesmer. He treated his patients through animal magnetism. He was actually using the magnet as well as the hands. He was thinking that, you know, it's the system of healing based on the disturbance of universal energy field. He was using his hands over the body and also with the magnets in his therapy. A magnet and later a hand to heal the disease. He found that his hands were also doing the similar work that of a magnet. During the time of Milton Erickson, who is the modern father of hypnosis, Milton Erickson, he was telling that it's really amazing what people can do, only they don't know what they can do. This is something which he was talking about. Maybe I'll the therapy regained popularity during his time, and both American as well as the British Medical Association, they recognized hypnotherapy as a valid medical procedure. If you go, even today, hypnotherapy is being used as a medical procedure in US and UK. The term hypnosis comes from the Greek word hypnos, meaning sleep. Hypnotherapists use exercises that bring about deep relaxation and an altered state of consciousness, also known as a trance. If you talk in terms of hypnosis, there is hypnosis doesn't begin or end without a trance. It's called as trance, a deep kind of a relaxation technique. A person in a deeply focused state is unusually responsive to an idea or image. But this does not mean that a hypnotist can control the person's mind and free will. There is no control. If at all somebody is doing something against his will, it is not not true. During hypnosis, nobody does anything without his own consent. On the contrary, hypnosis can actually teach people how to master their own states of awareness. This is very surprising and contradictory to the belief. By doing so, they can affect their own bodily functions and psychological responses. The term hypnosis comes, contrary to a popular misconception that hypnosis is not a unconscious sleep, it is resembling sleep. Contemporary research says that it is a wakeful state. of it's a wakeful state of focused attention, heightened suggestibility with the diminished peripheral awareness. What do you mean by peripheral awareness? Have you ever engrossed in a book while reading? You have missed a lot of things, you know, which were going around, going on in your vicinity or in your room. Have you gone through? Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Many times.
Yeah, many times. You can definitely be a subject. If at all anybody feels that, you know, you go into fully into the book or while watching some serials or movies, you do not know what is happening around you. You are getting into a state of hypnosis. Whether hypnosis happens for everybody, every day, yes. during our you know, all the activities, suppose, you know, you go to a shop, say to buy one or two items from the, say, shopping mall, and surprisingly you come back with the bag fulls of things with you, right? Things which you do not require, then also, you know, those things you buy. What is the reason that you buy? Though we may call it as impulse you buy, it is not an impulse. It is a subconscious mind. The need for those things is pent up, piled up in your subconscious mind. And that is what tells you, you buy these things, buy these things. You are already hypnotized. Children are very easily hypnotized. And because of children, parents are buying things which they don't require. A lot of things they don't require. This is the effect of hypnosis. These marketeers, they have understood the impact of this hypnotism very, very clearly. And that is the reason they market in such a way that you are hypnotized. You are hypnotized through the words. You are hypnotized through the pictures. You are hypnotized through the moving images. You are hypnotized through the words. So there are different types of hypnotism mechanism that is going on. The latest hypnotizing mechanism is from the Milton Erickson. He uses these techniques for hypnotizing people. Milton Erickson, that is, it's called as conversational hypnosis. You might have heard while going through hypnosis. It's a conversational hypnosis. It's also called as covert hypnosis. There is something called self-hypnosis. You don't have to go to a hypnotist for hypnotizing yourself. You can do your own hypnosis. It's called as self-hypnosis. These are called also as auto-suggestion, self-suggestion or auto-suggestion. Or very recently, you can find on the internet thousands and thousands of material, pages of material, wherein they say affirmations, positive thinking. There are hundreds of books on positive transformation, the personal transformation, individual transformation, transformation of the mind, so transformation of the subconscious mind, how to change your subconscious beliefs. So all these are coined in the 21st century. It's a 21st century is a century of auto-suggestions. The use of hypnotism for therapeutic purposes is referred to as hypnotherapy. In fact, today's session is on hypnotherapy. So we will talk a little more on hypnotherapy, how hypnotherapy or hypnosis can be used for alleviating our illnesses. Using hypnotherapy to promote healing or positive development in any way is known as hypnotherapy. it is absolutely, there is no change from hypnosis and hypnotherapy. If you use hypnosis for the purpose of healing, it's called as hypnotherapy. The methods, the setting, the people, the kind of purpose, the purpose should be for therapy. Here, you know, I would like to mention some things about stage hypnosis. How many of you have heard stage hypnosis? Hypnosis for fun. Rather, in the name of magic, people use hypnosis. That is stage hypnosis. You may ask a question that whether the stage hypnosis is true, whether people are, I do not know what kind of stage hypnosis you have seen, but I have seen some of the shows, stage shows on hypnosis, saying that, you know, when we were students, maybe we were high school students, we were made to dance, we were made to act like monkeys, we were made to cry like, you know, babies. We were asked to imitate the cries of birds and animals, all through hypnosis. You can ask, you know, what is this? Whether this hypnotist has captured the mind of the students or the subjects? No. How this happens is, you know, the hypnotist, he prepares these students or his subjects before coming on the stage or before actually getting into the kind of things that he is telling the people to do. And that is about say 25 to 30%. Remaining 70%, you can see only those people, those who are wanting to show off, those who are wanting to explicitly show some behavior, they volunteer and they go on the stage. It is not that, you know, they have captured the mind or he had the power to control of the mind. No, it is not like that. It is for show. It is for fun. So this is called as stage hypnosis. What we are talking today here is the hypnotherapy, usually deployed to tackle psychological problems within the mind, as this is where hypnosis can be very powerful. Here, one thing you might have noticed that hypnosis has been used over a period of almost 200 years now, two centuries, or in different periods. Sometimes, you know, it was flourishing, sometimes it was coming down. In fact, some of the kings, you know, those who were ruling, they banned hypnosis, and later on, you know, they reinstalled. Roman Catholic Church, Christians, they banned hypnosis. Today, you see that Pope himself, he has permitted the use of hypnosis. What I'm saying is, you know, we hypnotists don't use any other weapon. We use only the mind for the benefit of the client. Some of you may wonder, how is that, you know, we have read stories of hypnotized people going and killing somebody or stealing something or doing some wrongful things to the people. Actually, it is not possible to remotely control the mind, except if you have seen today the games, the PUBG games or the other internet games. What does it happen? How does it happen? It happens through internet, right? Somebody can unmute and answer.
Yes, sir.
It happens through internet. It is strange, isn't it? What do they control? They control the mind, isn't it? They control the mind. And being somewhere, there is a route, there is a method to control. I am talking to you now, and you are listening to me, and I am building up a positive response from you for hypnosis. You need to understand that, you know, the power is there in the words that is spoken. The power is there in the energy flows through the words, and the energy is absorbed by the person who listens, who sees, and who experiences. So hypnosis can be very powerful. It can be very powerful. And all these internet games today, they are using this this technology. They are using technology for capturing the mind. Hypnotherapy can reprogram patterns of behavior within the mind and can be effective in overcoming phobias, irrational fears, addictions, and negative emotions. I have practically experienced this as a person, as a hypnotist. Sometime back, one girl came to me for saying that, you know, she has the fear of, she was going abroad, traveling abroad, and she was having fear. And she was telling that, you know, when she gets into the aircraft, she feels like vomiting. So I did two sessions with her, and she traveled abroad without any difficulty. And after going there, and she messages me saying that, you know, thanking me for the help that, you know, I have rendered. Actually, I have not helped her. I have only assisted her in controlling her condition. Hypnotherapy has been successfully used to perform surgery on fully conscious patients who would be in obvious agony if not for the use of hypnosis. This is very strange. The person is fully conscious, but the surgery is being done, especially for the dentistry, dental surgeries. Hypnosis is being continuously used. If not in India, in abroad, it's being used. As I earlier said, James S. Dale, a Scottish surgeon, he is actually a surgeon, MD. He came to India and performed more than 2,000 painless surgeries through hypnosis. If you Google, you will find that in West Bengal, during those days, this is, I'm talking about, you can see the 1808 and 1859. He was made in the 2-3 hospitals. He was made the dean and the chief of the hospitals. And he performed a good many number of surgeries. You need to understand one thing. During those days, there was no painkillers or anesthesia. Only the ether was used as anesthesia or the anesthesia at a very, very late stage. Ether had not been invented during that time. There are a few questions. These are 5 questions that I have posed. Once you get the answers for these, you can definitely understand what hypnosis is. Okay, can anyone be hypnotized? Yes. Everybody can be hypnotized, except, as I told you, that, you know, the patients, mental patients. Everyone is suggestible to some degree. We cannot say that, you know, everybody to a very great extent, he is a suggestible candidate. We call it as suggestibility. 20% of the people can be hypnotized to the point where they do not smell a strong odor. Even if there is a very strong odor, if we hypnotize, they won't realize. Same thing, the opposite also would be true. Even if there is no odor, if we say that, you know, there is a very staunch smell of something, they will feel that smell. And definitely whatever actions they will have to do, avoiding that smell, they will do. Typically, they have they live a very rich fantasy lives. Here, one thing is which helps a hypnotist is the imagery. If a person is able to image or imagine or visualize, he is a good subject for the hypnotist. My own experience, there was one adolescent boy who had come to me for some correction of his own mind. I asked him whether he can visualize something. He was telling that I can't visualize. There are some people, those who cannot visualize, maybe, you know, through trial and error method, you know, we can do that. Can hypnosis enhance recall of forgotten events? If you have forgotten something, hypnosis will not make you to remember that. You can see memory does not record anything. Forgetting takes place immediately after the event. If at all you have to forget, it takes place immediately after the event. If you can't remember it awake, you can't remember it asleep. Can hypnotists do something against their will? No. An authoritative person in a legitimate context can induce people, hypnotized or not, to perform some unlikely events. You will have to be in an authoritative position. Then you can do anything, whether you are a hypnotist or not. For example, parents. If the parents say that, you know, to the children, you do something, children will obey. It is not hypnotism. It is the authority. But we have something called authoritative hypnosis, wherein the hypnotist uses his authority. Normally, this was being used earlier, but now it is not being used. Today's hypnosis is cooperative hypnosis. The overt behaviors of hypnotic subjects are well within normal limits. You can understand this whole concept. Can hypnosis be therapeutic? Yes. That's what we have been talking about. Hypnosis and positive suggestions like placebos changes people's expectations. You must be definitely aware of what placebos are and what placebos here, placebo effect. It is something, it is very extensively used in the medical field. Hypnosis cannot treat willpower issues. If you don't have willpower, hypnosis will not help you to increase your willpower. Willpower is a conscious thing. If you want to do something, you will do something. That is conscious. What hypnotists do is with the unconscious mind. Can hypnosis alleviate pain? The 50% can experience post-hypnotic pain reduction. As I have already said, in 1996, there was this slide is explaining the American experience. 10% can become so hypnotized as to undergo surgery without anesthesia. 10% is a huge, huge number. Just imagine, 10% of the population, those who require surgery, is a huge population. And they can be hypnotized without the anesthesia. And in fact, they use hypnosis or hypnotherapy for people, those who have the reactive effects of anesthesia. How hypnosis works? It works through parasympathetic activation, brain wave changes to alpha from beta. I will come to the next slide where, you know, there are four different stages, alpha, beta, theta, and delta. Right brain activation. Right brain is known for feelings, visualization, intuition, etc. With the left brain deactivation, when the hypnotist activates the right brain, his feelings, visualization, capacity for intuition increases. Whereas the left brain, it's a logical brain, which is more on facts, it goes under deactivation. There is also, you know, no ego. The suppression of ego comes. And for the period of hypnosis, the dissociation of the consciousness takes place. That is, your conscious brain goes to sleep. There are two minds. I would have asked a question, how many minds are there? Actually, there are two minds. One is the conscious mind, and another is the subconscious mind. And the unconscious mind is a part of the subconscious mind. The conscious mind is the mind in a wakeful state. This is the analytical part of the mind. It analyzes everything. It asks questions. It wants every detail about every information that comes your way. And I was talking about these different waves. You can actually find these waves, you know, through EEC. It is called as electroencephalogram. Beta, alpha, theta, and delta. Painless surgeries are done in the theta level. Okay. The subconscious mind is the storehouse of permanent memories that is highly organized and practically unlimited. The permanent memory acts as an internal library. Here we store the experience that we have been going through our lives. This is a data bank for everything which is not in your conscious mind. It is stored in our subconscious mind. Anything that is not in our conscious mind is stored in our conscious mind. If you see on the right-hand side, it's the beliefs, emotions, habits, values, protective reactions, long-term memory, imagination, and intuition. All these are stored in the subconscious mind. What the hypnotist tries to do is to change these beliefs or emotions, or do some changes in the subconscious mind, which is not possible in the conscious mind. The unconscious mind. Sorry? Are we running out of time?
No, sir. Please continue.
Okay.
No, sir. I think somebody is unmuted. That's
somebody has unmuted.
Okay, okay. The unconscious mind, which I was talking about, there are some people, those who say that, you know, there are three parts in the mind, this unconscious mind, subconscious mind, and the unconscious mind. Actually, the unconscious mind is part of the subconscious mind. This unconscious mind, we cannot do anything. Anything means we cannot do anything. We can do nothing in this. It is a part of our subconscious mind. It controls our breathing, our heart rate, our functioning of our inner organs. I cannot change the heart rate. I cannot change the heart pumps the blood. We cannot have to consciously remember about these functions running of these parts of this body. Just imagine if we have to remember to breathe, what would happen? We would have died by now. All these functions are automatical, so that the function is in the unconscious mind. How hypnosis happens? This is a this is the secret that I'm sharing with you. I have never shared this with any of the people so far. This is the secret that I'm sharing since you have so lovingly invited me to share my experience. Okay. The conscious mind and the subconscious mind is separated by a so-called watch guard. This is called as the critical factor. The critical factor's job is to take any new information you observe and compare it to the beliefs you have already stored in the subconscious mind. If this new information is in conflict with your beliefs, the critical factor will refuse the new information and it will not enter the subconscious mind. Some people have a belief that hypnosis is bad. As a hypnotist, I find it very difficult to hypnotize that person, but I can hypnotize. It's not that I cannot. I can hypnotize, but we may have to, as a hypnotist, I'll have to try a bit hard. Okay, remember this critical part. The core beliefs, if the new information has nothing to be compared to, critical factor will store it in that part of the subconscious mind that is designed for storing possible future beliefs. But let's wait till you have more information on this. the duty of the critical part is to compare whatever beliefs that are stored. For example, think that there is something stored in your subconscious mind. Maybe a simple thing like eating non-vegetarian food is bad. Eating non-vegetarian food is bad. And somebody gives a non-vegetarian food for a person. Suppose I eat with my belief saying that eating non-vegetarian food is bad. What would happen? We would suppose you come to know that you have eaten the non-vegetarian food. The possibilities are you immediately omit. You feel discomfort in your stomach. You feel a sense of guilt. You feel a lot of other things in your body as well as in your mind. The critical factor which has been guiding, if it is very very alert, it will not allow you. Consciously, you will not do. This is the image, the picture that is given here. If we bypass this critical factor, we get into the subconscious mind of the person. And what hypnotist does is he gets into the subconscious mind and makes all the changes. From beta, he comes to alpha. From alpha, he comes to theta. From theta, the yogis, the people, monks who are there in the Himalayas or Tibet, those people, it is said that they can even get into the delta stage. This is the pure meditation stage. You can ask me, what is the difference between the hypnosis and meditation? In hypnosis, we bring about the changes. We want the changes to make here, we can do in hypnosis. In meditation, we don't do any changes. What happens during hypnosis? The only headlines I will read. First is we put the person into relaxation, then remove resistance that he may have, then we bypass the critical conscious mind, then we access the subconscious mind. The therapeutic uses of hypnosis is it can even change the beliefs in a person, pain and anxiety. It can be helpful in dementia. It can be helpful in depression. It can be used in skin conditions. This is a very interesting part. Several skin conditions can be cured or changed. Post-surgical recovery, surgeons sometimes employ hypnotherapists to supplement anesthesia in some rare cases where patients are allergic in chemicals in anesthesia. This is what I said earlier. Again, relief from nausea and vomiting, the childbirth, treatment in hemophilia. Hemophilia is thinning of the blood. Smoking cessations, this is very extensively used abroad. Various kinds of addictions. I have used this in smoking, in nail biting, and such other addictions. Weight loss is one of the very effective uses of hypnosis. In the personal development, to increase the self-confidence, wipe out any limitations, unhealthy habits, to get motivated, inspired, or organized, to raise your self-esteem, help change aspects of your behavior for better. In personalized therapy, what happens is, we prepare individual scripts. It varies according to the individual's requirement. It's not that, one size fits all. If I use hypnosis for, somebody, it is a personalized script that I'm using. That's the reason I take the case history of the person in the beginning and his likes, his dislikes, his mental status, everything, we take just like any other case history in the mental illnesses. Unlike other conventional therapies, hypnotherapy requires client's cooperation. pills and all, you know, you can simply put in the mouth of the child and say that, you know, you are you can get cured. But whereas hypnosis is not like that. You require the patient's or the client's cooperation. And from the hypnotist side, it requires skill for the hypnotist. It requires imagination for the clients. Well-informed, confident, and experienced therapist can derive the maximum benefit. Thank you so far as the presentation is concerned. I have a practical demo wherein, you know, you need to give me 10 minutes time so that, you know, I can take you through a process of relaxation. I don't call it as hypnosis. You experience that, it would be very nice. I was telling whoever, you know, listens to me, I was telling, if somebody puts me to into hypnosis, I would be the happiest person, because I want to get into hypnosis. And we have our programs, and we go through on the previous day of our program, we go through hypnosis through the other person. They put us into hypnosis. We feel relaxed. Okay.
Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah.
It was very nice. Wonderful presentation.
Thank you.
Very informative also.
Thank you. Maybe after practical session for just 10 to 11 minutes, we can have. Do we have that time for?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We have.
No issues.
Okay. Do you want to have the questions now or later?
Later, sir.
Later. Okay. How many people are there right now?
65.
We have 65 in Zoom and 9 in YouTube, sir.
Okay. For all the people, those who are listening to me, are you in a comfortable place right now?
Yes, sir.
Why I'm asking this is, you know, right now we will be getting into a relaxed position. Okay, choose a place where you can feel very relaxed, and even when you are relaxed, you would be comfortable. Okay, you can just listen to me. If you have any other your phone's on active mode, you can put it on mute, and any other sounds you can block, and you can be in a room wherein no sudden guests come and knock the door, so that you will not be disturbed. Okay, these are the only requirements. Other than that, everything is fine. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. People, those who are not doing this relaxation exercise, they need not listen, because if you don't listen and get into this, you will not get the benefit of this. That's the reason. Okay. Take a comfortable position. Take a deep breath. Yes, that's right. Now, take a second deep breath. That's right. Now, slowly focus your eyes on some spot on the wall or whatever is there in front of you above the level of your eyes. Just focus on that. Keep that gaze for a few seconds. Now you feel that your eyes are getting drowsier and drowsier, and you want them to close at a particular point of time. If you want them to close now, you can close them now. Yes, let them close slowly. That's right. Now you feel like relaxing your head, and maybe you may wish to put your head down. If you wish, you can slowly put your head down. That's right. Now you will notice that your eyelids have become so drowsy and relaxed. You feel them to be kept closed and relaxed. Even if you want them to open, you won't be able to open. The more you try, the more tight and relaxed they become. Even if you try, be comfortable in this position. Now pay attention to the muscles of the forehead and let those muscles completely relax. And recognize that to be successful in any hypnosis, it's very simple. All you have to do is follow the suggestions. So if a thought is suggested, then think that thought. If a feeling or emotion is suggested, then bring forth the feeling. And if a belief is suggested, then in that moment, imagine it to be absolutely true. So these thoughts are very simple thoughts. So create for yourself a feeling of ease and comfort, a feeling that is even more enjoyable than just a moment ago. When you notice that the feeling, you take in a deep breath, and as you let it out and settle into that feeling of ease and comfort, and recognize that you created that feeling. You are the one in complete control of your mind, and you created that feeling, the feeling of relaxation. You simply follow the suggestion and notice as you are relaxing even deeper how easily the eyes and eyelids, they are closed just naturally. They stay closed. Relax the eyes and the eyelids even further so that they just continue to remain closed. The eyes are closed now. The eyelids stay closed because you make it so. You are the one in complete control. You simply follow the suggestion. Now, as relaxed as you are, double your relaxation. Then double it again and begin now to imagine yourself playing a child's game where you find yourself inside your mind with your eyes closed, and you see right in front of you is a black box. An ordinary black box, no more than knee high. Until you open it and it's filled with vast emptiness in which you can throw anything in it and it will simply fall away. And now is the time for you to throw away all your worries, whatever worries that you have, you throw them inside. Your doubts, you throw them inside. Your hesitations, you throw them inside. And if you like, throw away all your conscious awareness right now and seal up the box. And before sealing, you just see whether you have thrown all your disbeliefs, all your doubts, all your infirmities, all that you feel that it is not possible, you put that in the box. And the magic is, whatever you have put, it has vanished. It fades into eternity. Just look into the box. Nothing is there, absolutely. Now close the box and throw it away. Swing and swing, swirl and swirl. It will go away. Now your mind is open for all the suggestions that I am giving. Now I would like you to use your imagination. Imagine your own mind as a garden. You are the gardener and you are planting seeds. The seeds are your thoughts. All day long, you are planting thoughts or seeds in your subconscious mind based on the way you normally think. Every day, more than 50,000 thoughts come to our mind. And now is the time for you to pick up those seeds, those positive seeds that you have come to your mind. The way you think and sow your seeds in your subconscious mind, the same way you will be reaping the rewards in your body and your surroundings. As you sow, so shall you reap. From now on, you must begin to sow new seeds. You must plant seeds of peace. You must sow the seeds of happiness. Sow the seeds of health, good health, right action, prosperity, and wealth. Now think quietly on the qualities that you would like to sow in your garden, that is your mind, and accept them fully in your conscious reasoning mind. Continue to plant these wonderful seeds in the garden of your mind. And as you grow, you will reap the benefits of your deepest desires. To help you out with the new thoughts or the seeds, think of the abundance that the universe has given you. A very healthy and completely fit body. Every part of your body is functioning normally. Every joint is perfect. Every limb is working effortlessly and with ease. All the inner organs of the body are working to their optimum efficiency. And that is the way they are designed and gifted to us to perform. You will notice right now, at this very moment, your body has picked up any missing link to perform to its ultimate, maximum, and natural perfection. Send this feeling across your body. Change the way that you think from now on. You no longer end a negative statement. When you find yourself saying something negative, immediately stop yourself and finish it positively. Each positive statement is planting a positive seed. Your subconscious mind takes everything literally. And when you make a negative statement or a negative or a positive statement, it will do everything possible within its power to make these statements come true. I repeat, when you think negative, the negative will happen. When you think positive, and positive will happen. This is the quality of the subconscious mind. You realize that. From now on, you want only positive statements, such as, I can afford it. I can do this. More rightly, I am positive. The law of life is law of belief. A belief is a thought in your mind. Believe in the power of your subconscious mind. Believe in the power to heal, in the power to strengthen, and the cause you to succeed. What the mind can conceive and believe, the mind can achieve. That is your subconscious mind. From now on, you are always on the lookout for good, positive opportunities. New opportunities easily and frequently come your way. You are on top of your game and recognize all opportunities as they occur. You always seem to be at the right place at the right time from now on. Change your thoughts and change your destiny. See yourself the way you want to be. Imagine yourself right now as the prosperous person that you would like to be. Realizing that you have a right to be this person, you deserve prosperity, health, and happiness. These are natural to you. Therefore, imagine the natural you as that of healthy, happy, and prosperous person. Get it clearly in your mind. Imagine yourself as a wealthy person, as a prosperous person. you have enough to wear, you have enough to eat, you have enough to share, you have plenty to enjoy your life, for all your payments, for all your luxuries that you have been longing for. You will develop a mindset of a wealthy and prosperous person. This person that you are imagining right now is you. Accept it as you. Allow it to become you. Most of the times, the difficulty is not allowing it. Allow it. Allow it to become you. As you accept it and acknowledge yourself as this healthy, happy, and prosperous person, so will it become. Commit everything to this person, to memory. How you look, how you feel, and how you are behaving, so you can remember and see yourself as this person as often as possible. As long as you can keep these positive thoughts and memories alive, they will become your reality. From now on, you are always keeping positive and open-minded. The seeds of positive thoughts that you have sown, so passionately sown, will grow to bear positive fruits. This will change your life every day. This will change your life, and you will become better and better every day. In just a moment from now, I will count five. And after that count of five, I will snap my fingers. And when I do, you will be fully awake, feeling better than before, and very, very energized. One, you will slowly start emerging from hypnosis. Two, feeling energized and alert. Three, in just a moment, when I snap my fingers, you will feel better and better than ever before. Four, your eyelids are fluttering and your eyes are beginning to open. And five, feeling energized, alert, and better than before. You can rub your palms, two palms, and give the warmth into your eyes. Everybody is awake?
Yes, sir. Fresh and relaxed.
Thank you. You would feel fresh and relaxed, yes, if you have listened to me carefully and internalized what I have said. You would feel very, very relaxed. You can also do this as a self-hypnosis. You can always give affirmations, and the everyday affirmations also you can download from the internet, and you can make it happen in your lives.
Definitely, I will do, sir.
Anything that you want. In fact, as you have, as Mr. Srinivas Murthy has introduced me, I'm a law of attraction trainer. And whatever I am today, whatever the educational qualifications, that is one part, the academic part that I have done. I have, do you know who is the very rich person in the place where I am staying?
Bangalore?
Yeah.
No ideas.
It's me. It's me. I am the richest person.
I think not financially.
No, I never said that. I never said that. Yeah, finance is only one part of that. Health and happiness is another part.
Thank
okay. You. Yeah. Any questions that you would like to ask?
Sir, in chat box.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In chat, we have a couple of questions, sir.
Yeah. Yeah.
Shobha, ma'am. Can addiction be cured through hypnosis?
Absolutely. Addiction can definitely be cured. In fact, I have worked with a couple of people on addiction. The only thing is, the person addicted has to come to me when he is not into that addiction. Like, a person addicted to drinks. If a person comes to me with fully drunk, I will not be able to do anything.
Yes, sir.
If a person comes to me with the pawn, I will not be able to do anything. The person has to come without that substance. We can work. And he needs to have a desire.
Sir, I'm Shobha, exactly for that question.
Yeah.
I asked that question. So, my husband is an alcoholic, but he's also very resistant to the idea of going to a psychiatrist or going for this thing. So, how do I even convince him to seek help?
So, there are two things. One is, a clinical psychologist, psychiatrist.
Yeah, we did go to a clinical psychiatrist, but after 2-3 sessions, he got very resistant. He stopped going. So this process has been going on and off. That's why I wondered if, like, in hypnotherapy, there is some auto-suggestion and all that.
See, as you, I have explained, so, and as you have undergone, what happens is, in hypnosis, we get into the subconscious mind.
Yeah.
And in subconscious mind doesn't judge. It only accepts suggestions.
Okay.
Whether positive or negative, it accepts suggestions. There is no judging. So there, what we need to do is, we need to give suggestions which are accepted. No judging question, no critical mind. So a skillful hypnotherapist will definitely be able to do it.
Okay.
But not in 1 or 2 sessions.
I understand that.
Yeah. It takes maybe, a good many sessions, maybe 10 or 15 or 20. But then, once the person feels that, yes, I am getting benefited, then there is no stopping. He gets it.
Okay. So can we, how do I contact you or come? Can we do that?
Bangalore.
Yeah, I'm in Bangalore.
You are in Bangalore.
I'm in Bangalore.
Yeah. If you find out, there would be a lot of hypnotists in Bangalore. There would be, we can even through NLP also, we can try. NLP is a part of the hypnosis.
Okay.
There also, there are good NLP practitioners are there.
Okay.
You can definitely do it. I can give you hopes that this can be done. You need to definitely use this for your health. Whoever it is, and whatever addictions, even smoking cessation.
Yeah.
Alcohol. Smoking is more difficult than alcohol.
Okay. Yeah.
Quitting
has both the addictions.
Yeah, both are addictions. Smoking is more difficult.
No, he has both the addictions, I said, smoking and alcohol.
Yeah, someone is telling that, there is de-addiction at NIMHANS itself. I think perhaps, you can just check.
Okay.
Okay. Any other questions?
There, some people claim that it can be cured remotely, thousands of miles away. Can it be done? Remote hypnosis.
Yeah, you need to. We need to try. I have not tried hypnosis in a remote place. In the sense, you know, the kind of effects that you are getting. Have you all been in trance during my session, the hypnotherapy session? Have you been in trance?
Yes,
no.
Sir.
Yes, I fell asleep, sir.
Not in a trance, but in a relaxed state.
Relaxed.
Yeah, that is the trance.
Not a trance.
That is the. Did you disbelieve? Did you disbelieve what I said? Anytime?
No, sir.
No, you all believed. That is the positive effect of that. And no,
but what you
that
said was plausible.
Sorry?
See, what you said was plausible, and there was nothing there which was contradictory to our beliefs, so that we don't believe you.
Absolutely. Hypnosis, only that. As a hypnotist, or any hypnotist for that matter, we don't get into contradictory statements or suggestions. Hypnosis is nothing but suggestions. You accept the suggestions. Your subconscious mind accepts the suggestions. And these suggestions are in tune with your memory bank in the subconscious mind. That is how hypnosis works. If the memory bank, which is there, it coincides with what suggestions that we have been giving. There is somebody who says, ask one question, I will reply that. Hypnotists only corroborate your positivity that you have in you, in your subconscious mind. So that is easier through these words or suggestions or affirmations. It is possible to get into that. Even for addiction, if a person says every day that knowing fully well that, you know, it is difficult for him, if he says that, you know, every day I am making an effort. Don't say try. Trying is not, you know, effort. I am making an effort. I always tell people, trying is something. Most of the people, I will try every day. No, trying is not personal. Trying is something, you know. You just, as a third person, you see something else. Like, think that, you know, I'm in front of you. I give this pen to you. I offer this pen to you. Can you try to take it? Don't take it. Try to take it.
No.
You can't.
No.
Either you take it or don't take it. There is nothing in between trying. Most of the subconscious mind is like that. Never say that, you know, I will try to be happy. I will try to get rid of my habit. It doesn't happen. So this is a basic thing which differs from a person. Even highly motivated person, he says, every day I am trying here to say do this, to get rid of this habit. It doesn't happen. I am trying means what? You try to take this pen without taking it. You only try, but you won't take it. Ultimate result is you are not taking it. But make an effort to take it. Stretch your hand. Put down your, bring together your fingers and take it. You are making an effort. Our subconscious mind is like a child's mind. You need to, what are your beliefs after all? How to form the beliefs? How to form the beliefs? Do you know how your beliefs are formed in you, in us? Beliefs are statements which you have been repeating over and over and over and over again, right from your childhood. How does the habit form? By repetition. How do the beliefs form? Like faith. my belief in Christianity, your belief in Hinduism, somebody else's belief in, Judaism, it's a belief. How did it happen? Over and over again, right from childhood, you know, we have been going, brought up in that environment. These beliefs are formed. And how to change these beliefs? When you smoke, what was the belief that the person has got? The belief with emotion. Nobody has smoked any cigarette or any ganja or anything that, you know, intoxicating for on his own. It has been offered. They were invited. They were tempted. Then only they have started. Then, you know, they linked it to the pleasure. Our emotions also work with the pain and pleasure principle. The more pleasure you get, the more deep-rooted will your belief be. It's very difficult. Then after a certain time, what happens is, you know, the whole nervous system in the body, it becomes very receptive to whatever that is injected or given to us. Why do we get hungry? We are seasoned to take food. Why an alcoholic wants to drink? There's a whole theory of persons getting alcoholics. Okay, we'll move to the other question. One of the questions that I saw is strong-willed people cannot be hypnotized. I had told in the beginning itself. There is nothing like strong will or weak will. A strong-willed person will be a very easy target for hypnotism. But a person who is very critical, very, very critical, we have got, you know, different methods of hypnotizing them. It's called the suggestibility. There are different, for the critical person, we have got different methods. There are hundreds of ways through which, you know, we can hypnotize a person. It doesn't give credit to a person saying that, you know, I cannot be hypnotized. It is his weak will. We need to get ourselves hypnotized by good things. That's what I said. I want to get myself hypnotized. And that's why I do a lot of self-hypnosis. And whenever we go to Bangalore for the sessions, we get ourselves hypnotized. That's how, you know, we keep ourselves, talents alive. Okay, any other questions which...
Yes, sir. Yeah. Some more are there.
Yeah, tell me.
Is it related to past life regression therapy?
No. It's hypnosis is, you know, you can get into the past life also. Regression. But I don't I don't have that much of belief in past life. But regression is, you know, my own life. Past life means, you know, people have a misconception that, you know, before getting this human life, what was my past life? We are not talking about that. We are talking about, you know, when you are a child. When you are a child, what were the things, you know, that you have done? The regression, we get into the regression mode and method.
In the same life.
The past. There are a lot of people, those who say that, you know, it's a past life, earlier life, you know, you are there. There was a TV serial also. There was a TV serial where, you know, people were telling that, you know, in the past life, I was like this. It was all, you know, dramatized. And later on, you know, a lot of rationalists, you know, they objected for that serial, and that serial was stopped. We do not know. It's all the fantasy of the person, you know, who is talking. It's a fantasy. I can say like that, you know, I jokingly tell my children that, you know, in the past life, I was a king. So you were all the prodigy of the king. Just to keep the morale up. Yeah, anything else?
Any participants would like to ask any questions?
There was some question.
Yes, sir. Thangaraju has asked use of hypnotherapy in day-to-day life.
Yeah.
They have already answered it.
Yeah, yeah. Get into self-hypnosis.
Yes.
It's very good. It's very good. Download a good recording. I have, if you want, I can send you. I have got good self-hypnosis, this one, PDFs. I can send if
please
you,
please share it, sir.
Anybody, I will share. And you play it. You do it in your own voice recording.
Sure.
Now a lot of in the mobile also you can record and play it every day.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sir, self-talk is also hypnotherapy.
Sorry.
Self-talk.
Self-talk. Yeah, so it's called as affirmations. Affirmations are the placebos in the medical language. I call recently. I talked on placebos in the Mangalore Management Association. I was talking about the placebo effect, how it happens, and the difference between the placebo effect and the affirmations. Affirmation or self-talk is boosting your own ego. Whereas, in hypnosis, what happens is, ego is not there. Ego gets sleep. It goes to sleep, the ego. You do not know that, I'm so and so, I have these many connections. And all this egoistic kind of talks are not there. Self-talk has to happen in the form of affirmations.
But self-talk can also be negative,
If
it is self-talk, positive, then only it's an affirmation.
Yes. Oh, yeah, you talked, I don't think of negatives actually. Self-talk, most of the self-talks. How many thoughts, I have mentioned somewhere, how many thoughts come to our mind every day? 50 to 60,000 thoughts. Though nobody has kept a count on that, but they are even 10,000 or 15,000 thoughts are too many thoughts, isn't it? Out of that, you can see only 1% or 2% of the thoughts are positive. Just imagine. 99%, some psychologists say, there some papers, I have read some paper presentation, wherein they say that, about 80% of the thoughts are negative. In my own experience, I find that, about 90% of the thoughts are negative. Only 5 to 10% of the thoughts may be positive. And the negative thoughts, as you very rightly named them, are the self-talk. Self-talk is, I think, what shall I do if I'm getting late to the office? What does this person will think about me? So these are the self-talks. So we need to get over those. We need to change them as a positive thought. There was some mention there, the Zoom link was wrong. In fact, I had shared with 5 to 6 groups, and since the link was wrong, I do not know how many of that link group have joined. Doesn't matter, we do not know, mistakes do happen. We cannot actually, blame anybody on this. Yeah, anything else? I'm surprised. 89 people. Is there any classes to learn, and what is the qualifications required? For your information, I learned hypnosis when I went to US. There were a few courses there, and since my interest was there in this, and there is one organization in Bangalore called as Mind Matters. The person there teaches hypnosis. You can you can attend those classes. In fact, there is not much of a qualification required. Even Government of India has approved hypnosis as one of the therapies, but the only condition they have mentioned that, you know, it has to be done by an approved hypnotist. And they have not very clearly mentioned, you know, what are the requirements of an approved therapist. They say that they're a certified therapist. I have done my certification from the Mind Matters Institute. And some of the online portals in US, and there is one institute called Hypnosis Motivation Institute in UK. There they give a lot of good training, but if you go to their classes, it's very expensive. There was one in US also. It was free earlier. Now they have charged, they have started charging very exorbitantly. More questions are welcome. If you are not tired, I am not tired.
Not at all, sir.
Up to now, how many patients we have treated? Yes, whatever conversation happened recently. And we just, yeah, up to now, how many patients you have? My patients are of different kinds. Like, you know, I do counseling, I do hypnotherapy, I do career guidance. So not too many. Maybe about 200-300 patients in hypnotherapy. Hypnotherapy, quite a few. Maybe about 30-40. My therapies are mainly basing on phobias, addictions. There was, I'll share one, what do you call it, a good, episode. One girl of first year dentistry came to me. Her mother brought her to me, saying that, you know, she's having the habit of nail biting. I did one session of counseling and one session of hypnotherapy. And for the third session, I asked her, do you want to give up this habit? And she said, no. What does it say?
He's having some benefit out of it.
She is finding some benefits, and she explained to me what is the benefit that she gets. Then my job was to tell her that, you know, what are the negative points of her habit. So with a lot of convincing and a lot of changing, getting into the subconscious mind, she reduced. She has not totally given up. She reduced. Maybe, you know, now that she is in the final year of dentistry, she may not find time to nibble her fingers. I mean, nails. How long can you be in the state of hypnosis? Normally, about half an hour. You can. And the latest style of hypnosis is rapid hypnosis. I don't know whether you are aware of that.
No, sir.
We can put the patient into hypnotic state within a few seconds. We build that atmosphere. We bring the patient or the subject into a trance state, very, very close to that. And within a flick of the finger, the patient is in a hypnotic state. And to remain in that state, then we need to do the lot of exercise, subsequent exercises, to continue him to be in this. Dr. Newton, who is MD physician in Andhra Pradesh, is doing lots of work in hypnosis. Yes, there are a lot of Indians, those who are doing. As I mentioned, one Catholic priest, Father Abbe Faria from Goa, he did a lot of research in hypnosis, and it has been documented. Many people have been benefited out of it. Here, what is required is, you know, the motivation. Rightly, this UK Institute has been named as Hypnosis Motivation Institute. It depends, madam. Somebody is asking, you know, Ramamani is asking, how many sessions at an average, on an average it takes. At least, you know, somewhere between 3 to 5. In one session, nothing happens. If you think that, you know, today I have gone to the hypnotist and he has worked on me, one session, nothing happens. Just as the habits are formed through repetition, beliefs are formed through repetition. Similarly, it has to, the deep-rooted beliefs and the habits, if we have to remove those habits, we have to reprogram, rewire this. It's called, so far as the brain is concerned, it is rewiring. And recently, one of my doctors, he was talking about rewiring, how you know how it takes effect. Yeah, very informative session. Thank you for listening to me. I feel very privileged to be requesting one of the participants to present. Okay, I feel privileged to be talking to you, all you people, and Mr. Srinivas Murthy has been kind enough. He heard one of my sessions.
Yes, sir.
That was the reason, perhaps, you know, it...
I think 2 months ago.
Yeah, yeah.
2 months.
Yeah. What are the different methods? Can you put that again? What are the different methods, that question?
To activate right brain.
Activate right brain. These are the methods. I told you that, you know, when you are into get into hypnosis, your right brain is activated. And there are very simple things, like, you know, do things, you know, which you are doing in the right hand, replace them doing it in the left hand. Rewiring.
Nice.
Many things. And see, one part of the brain is, you know, it's very logical brain. And the other one is creative. So how to bring in harmony in these both brains? So what we do, that is the reason, you know, why do the critical, to surpass this or to get over this critical brain, we use imagery. We use imagery. If mathematics is taught through imagery or through visual this one methods, mathematics is easier for the children. Both parts of the brain is activated. The left brain is very critical brain. It wants facts and figures. Some people's imagery is very dull. Yeah, we need to. That's exactly what I was telling. This boy was not able to visualize certain things. I said, you know, can you describe it? Can you visualize what has happened? And can you describe this? The boy says, no, I can't visualize. So some people, you know, we may have to work on that. We may have to work on that imagery. Some people are very good. Why some people are very good in math? Some people are not good in math. I am very good in imagery. And it goes by saying that, without saying that, you know, I am not that good in math. Okay. And there are people, those who are both, you know, it's called a synthesis. Okay, thank you. I'm taking much of your time.
Yeah.
Can you. We wait for one more person? 99 plus. I think 100 people are there. Okay.
Yeah, 100. Century.
Oh, yeah.
First century.
Yeah.
Okay. So, yes, sir. So, I think we can wind up the session, sir. It was quite.
I would request Sudha, ma'am, Sudha Nagendra.
Yeah.
Ma'am, to present vote of thanks.
Sure, please. Yeah. So, from behalf of Vayuman Sanjini, and I would like to thank Dennis sir and Srinivas Murthy sir for moderating the session. It was really a wonderful and informative session. I hope all the attendees and the participants have enjoyed the session. Thank you once again, Dennis sir. Once again, I would like to apologize for the wrong,
I already said it. It's okay.
But sir, actually, the one which you have shared only this one, sir. Later, what I did is I just emailed this, the one which you have shared, sir, actually. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am.
The more we talk about it, perhaps you know it. The imprints would become more stronger. So we'll forget about it.
Sorry. Ee sandarbhadalli nanda innond request.
Okay.
Sir hatra kannada do ondu session ide tara maadi kotre innu baala janakke adu reach agutte anta. Ivattu because of the language issue baala jana join aagilla. ಕನ್ನಡದ ಒಂದು ಸೆಷನ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗೋದಾದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನು ಒಳ್ಳೇದು ಅಂತ ಸರ್.
ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಪುಟ್ ಮೈ ಎಫರ್ಟ್ಸ್.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್.
ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸೀ ಹೌ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡು ದಟ್.
ಸುಧಾ ನಾಗೇಂದ್ರ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಸರ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಎ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಅಮೇಝಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಪ್ನೋಥೆರಪಿ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸೈಕೋಥೆರಪಿ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಸೋ. So we know a little bit about psychotherapy and it is the same thing like putting in practice and making them to understand the situation and giving awareness. All those things are the different stages in this also. And it's really an informative session and also there were so many questions I could able to see that several people were asking is insomnia is curable or anything like that. So it creates a lot of curiosity in us. A painless therapy is available, which is also very, most of the people are not exposed to this hypnotherapy. And because of so many misconceptions which are given by some people who have malpracticed it or anything like that. But even I know a little bit about the hypnotherapy, not very much. I know it is really effective. And even I went into trance and I could not get a lot of the words what he has said in between. But I know it will be there in subconscious mind.
Absolutely. This is exactly what I wanted to tell you also. You don't have to understand also these words. The you might have skipped because I was a little fast. I know
The trance will
it accepts. Our subconscious mind will accept and it will be there, and whenever it is required it will come up.
Yeah That is the human brain power. And there is so much to learn. What we know is very little.
Even I am also I also keep learning. And I do a lot of things. I read journals. I read. I talk to people. I download the material from the internet. I go through that. I read it. I practice it. In fact, the script that you know I have this entire script is mine. I have prepared maybe you know some bits and pieces I have taken from different places and I have put it together. The script is mine, and this is how you know I do it during my hypnosis practice also. I prepare the script and according to the requirement of the client.
I could sense it because the flow, it was going so nicely. Yeah. And it was very reachable to everyone, common person. So thank you so much for the valuable information.
You are welcome, and I feel very thankful to all of you those have
shared some valuable distinct also points also.
So for me also, you know, it is it's an exposure. I can say that, you know, I was associated with an institute organization like Vayamanasa through our Srinivas Murthy.
People are in this.
See how, you know, I do law of attraction courses. Mm-hmm. See how we attract mm-hmm. things into our lives. Mm-hmm. I have never known Srinivas Murthy. He happened to log into some one of my talks,
and he's sharing his
sharing. See how the circle
so we
widens, the circle widens.
And Tina and everybody who are attracting this program, and thank you each and everyone. Thank you
very much. I will exit. I will leave.
ಮತ್ತೆ ಭೇಟಿ ಆಗೋಣ ಸರ್.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಸರ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಫಾರ್ ಜಾಯಿನಿಂಗ್ ಟುಡೇ ಸೆಷನ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ಐ ಶುಡ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಜೀನಾ ಫಾರ್
ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್
ನಾಟ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಡ್ ಶಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್
ದಟ್ಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಫೈನ್ ಸರ್.